Hello, children.
Hi, sir.
Today, I am telling you structure of chloroplast. Important question. Page number 10, unit 1, nutrition. All of you open your textbooks. So this is a revision class and revision question. All of you open your textbook. Unit 1, page number 10. Question may be asked like this. Describe the structure of chloroplast with the help of a label diagram. This is AS5 question. Or describe the structure of chloroplast. That is AS1 question. So two types of question may be you are observing. Describe the structure of chloroplast. That is AS1 question. Describe the structure of chloroplast or explain the structure of chloroplast with a label diagram. That is AS5 question. AS5 question is diagram based question. Diagram. So drawing skills. You need to draw the diagram and you need to explain the structure of chloroplast. Okay. All of you open page number 10. There you see structure of chloroplast. So this is chloroplast. And this chloroplast diagram is drawn by our student, your classmate, Narayan. So here this is the structure of chloroplast. And same structure of chloroplast also you are observing in your textbook, page number 10. Figure number 8. So it is disc shape, discoid shape, or more or less oval shape. And it consists of three membranes under it. It is a membranous structure. Three membranous structures. That means it is having three membranes. Outer, middle, and inner. So here you see, this is the inner layer. And this inner layer forms stacks. And these stacks are called thylakoids. So many filamentous structures are present. Many saccharine structures are present. And these are called thylakoids. Stroma thylakoids and grana thylakoids. And some of these stacks they form as stack. STLK stacks. And the stacks of thylakoid membranes are called grana. This is grana. So what is grana? Grana is nothing but stalks of thylakoid membrane. And that site is believed to be for the purpose of light reaction. Light reaction takes place in grana. And the intermediate portion, this is the colorless portion. That is present in the chloroplast is called stroma. This is called stroma. And this is called stroma. And this is called grana. This is called stroma. So two terms you need to understand. So first one is grana. Second one is stroma. What is grana? Grana is nothing but stacks of thylakoid membranes. And what is stroma? Stroma is nothing but intermediate fluid portion. Colorless fluid portion that is present in the chloroplast is called stroma. Grana, stroma. And this grana consists of what? Thylakoid membrane. This is thylakoid membrane. And this thylakoid membrane consists of chlorophyll pigment molecules. Many pigmented molecules are present. So the most important pigmented molecule that is present in the thylakoid is chlorophyll. The entire structure is chloroplast. In the thylakoid membrane, what are present? Chlorophylls are present. And they are pigmented molecules. Again, you see other pigmented molecules are present in addition to the chlorophyll. They are carotenoids and phycoblins. Other pigmented molecules are present along with the chlorophylls. But chlorophylls are present in more. And they are present in lumen, the empty space of thylakoid membrane. And these chlorophylls, they are useful for trapping sunlight. They absorb the sunlight. They fix the sunlight. and this sunlight is useful for what? What? This sunlight is useful for what? Production of energy molecules. Later I will tell you. So this is grana, this is stroma. And chlorophylls are two types. Chlorophylls are two types. And they are chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. You understand it? Chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Chlorophyll A, blue green color. Chlorophyll B, yellow green color. Okay. Later I will ask you some question. Please read and please understand. What is the color of chlorophyll A?
Blue green.
What is the color of chlorophyll B?
Yellow green.
So here you see 252, 400 chlorophyll molecules. They group together. They organize together. Form as reaction centers. Chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B. So here 252, 400 chlorophylls. They organize together as reaction centers. And here reaction centers are present. And these reaction centers are useful to trap the sunlight. Reaction centers are found by the grouping of chlorophylls. Chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B. 252, 400 chlorophyll, they group together form reaction centers. They trap sunlight. Reaction centers are useful to trap sunlight. Okay. Here, you see, this is grana, this is stroma. And chlorophyll consists of what? Magnesium atom. One magnesium atom. There you see. So chlorophyll consists of what? Magnesium. Naran, what is there? One magnesium atom. Again, hemoglobin or blood consists of one what? Iron atom. Is that in your textbook or not?
Yes, sir.
Chlorophyll consists of what? One atom of magnesium. And our hemoglobin blood consists of what? One atom of
magnesium, hemoglobin, iron.
Hemoglobin, iron. Chlorophyll, magnesium. Chlorophyll consists of one atom of magnesium. And our hemoglobin blood consists of one atom of iron. That is the difference between both chlorophyll and also hemoglobin. Okay. So here these are what? Grana. Grana are mainly useful for what purpose? To perform light reaction. They consist of what? Chlorophylls. Pigment molecules are present in the grana. Okay. Here light reaction takes place. Here dark reaction takes place. Now I am asking, where does light reaction take place in chloroplast?
Grana.
Where does dark reaction takes place in chloroplast?
Stroma.
Okay, stroma is site for what? Dark reaction. And the grana is site for light reaction. And next, I am telling you, just below the diagram, there you see three terms are there, three lines are there. So what are the major steps that takes place in during photosynthesis? Three, they are there. Here you see conversion of light energy to chemical energy. So here you see grana consists of chlorophyll. They convert light energy into chemical energy. That is NADPH and also ATP. That is first process. Next, splitting of water molecule. So here, chlorophyll, they trap the sunlight and they get the energy. And finally, they break the water molecule that is present in the grana. And finally, water molecule break into H plus and O2 and OH. So that is the second step, breaking of water molecule. And third one is reduction of carbon dioxide to carbon dioxide. And finally, reduction of carbon dioxide takes place, that is present in the carbon dioxide to carbon, and finally glucose molecule is produced after photosynthesis in case of chloroplast. And that is brief description about what? Chloroplast. Now I am asking few questions. Be ready. Gautami, you please come and stand here. Stand here. How many membranes are present in chloroplast?
Three membranes are present in chloroplast.
Outer membrane, middle membrane, and inner membrane. Three membranes are present. Again, second question I am asking. What are grana? What are grana?
Thylakoids of.
Many thylakoids they form as stars. Say bigger. They form as stars. Show me in the figure grana. So this is grana. Again, another one. This is grana. And this is grana. This is grana. This is. Next, third question. Come down, please come. Please come. Now I am asking another question. Show me the stroma. Show me the stroma. Stroma. Where is stroma?
This is stroma.
Yes, this is stroma, this is stroma, this is stroma, this is stroma. And like that you see. Intermediate fluid portion that is present in the chloroplast called stroma. Again, another question. Where does light reaction take place?
So, grana by grana.
Yes. Show me the grana.
This is grana.
This is grana. Like that many grana present in grana. Come here. In grana, light reaction takes place. And where does dark reaction take place?
Stroma.
In stroma, dark reaction takes place. So, what are present in thylakoid membrane? What pigmented molecules are present in thylakoid membrane?
Chlorophyll
A and chlorophyll B. And what is the color of chlorophyll A?
Blue and green.
Blue and green. Blue. What is the color of chlorophyll B?
Yellow green.
Yellow green. Again, and three important events that take place in photosynthesis. What are they?
Conversion of light and chemical energy.
First one is conversion of light and chemical energy.
Splitting of
water molecules.
Reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrate.
Okay, thank you. You explained very well. And today's question is, describe the structure of what? Chloroplast. Or describe the structure of chloroplast with the help of a Lebon diagram. Or explain the structure of chloroplast. Or explain the structure of chloroplast with the help of a Lebon diagram. Very important question. All of you read this question with joy. Don't feel bored. Interest you chadavandi. Automatic vastadi. Meeku anni easy unda steps. Deentlo kangaru padatam avasaram ledu. And this is essay question. And this question carries how many marks?
Six marks.
Section 3. Six marks. Okay, thank you.